You know, the Suicide Squad reminds me of the time, you know, when you were like younger and you used to hang out with all your friends and you kind of came up with these interesting premises of movies that stars random superheroes or cartoon characters.
Hey man,
what's up homie?
You know what I was thinking? That would be really, really cool if they made like a live action team up movie, man. Yo, that would be dope. With random characters, you know, like, you know, the Punisher teaming up with the Tick, Pastepot Pete, the dude from Greatest American Hero, The Crow, Dolomite, Chun-Li,
Bjork.
But then, you know, they had to fight this giant menacing villain.
Jaws.
Nah. Something more menacing.
Mysterio?
Oh no, I got it. Godzilla.
Yo, what?
Oh man, that would be great. Can you imagine if someone did a movie like that?
They gotta do that.
Wow. Can you pass me another Zima?
This movie is just like a ticking time bomb that just blows up in your face in the only way that James Gunn can muster. And I gotta tell you, I loved it every single minute. It's amazing how he has a real knack of taking a bunch of these low-level, unknown DC characters and made them all individually interesting and exciting to watch on the big screen, you know, just like what he's done with Guardians of the Galaxy. The Suicide Squad is a full-on James Gunn experience. I've been a fan of James Gunn since I saw Super. He has a certain style that carries along with him throughout all of his movies. This is a movie that really displays a lot of James Gunn's talents and really his signature styles. It's not for the faint of heart, I will tell you that. It's ultra violent, gory, and sometimes gross. It's batshit crazy when it comes to the overall action, the storylines, and the interactions with a lot of the characters. It also has an amazing soundtrack, just like what you would be used to with the Guardians movies. He also has a way of really bring in a lot of moments that have heart and warmth to it. There are a lot of moments with certain characters that, you know, kind of give you the feels. As far as the acting is concerned, Idris Elba is great as Bloodsport. I know he was in the Thor universe in the MCU, but here you get to really see more of him and more of his acting chops in a superhero type of movie. And he fits in just perfectly. Margot Robbie has made Harley Quinn her own, so she definitely shines. Casting Sylvester Stallone as the voice of King Shark was brilliant. And even though you don't really get to see Sly himself, the way he acted out the dialogue was really well done. Kudos to Gunn for his directing, but he made you really feel and interested in this CG character, just like how he did with a talking raccoon and a walking tree that only says three words over and over again. However, I have to say that my favorite breakout character of the movie was Polka Dot Man. I mean, who the hell would have thought I would say that Polka Dot Man is my favorite character in any movie. David Dasmalchian is a gem. You could really tell that James Gunn had a lot of fun creating the story for this character. And something that is more of a relief to me is John Cena. Let's face it, my last experience with Cena was with Fast 9. This is a movie that is built for Cena. He plays the straight-faced comedic character so well. Even the action scenes that he was in was believable and really entertaining. Also, I have to say, who would have thought that one of my all-time favorite obscure DC villains would actually work in a live-action movie setting? I lost my mind when I saw Starro kind of tease in the teaser trailers. I was losing my mind even more so when I finally saw it appear on the big screen. The great thing about this movie too is that you don't have to have seen the previous Suicide Squad movie. They did a really good job at, you know, explaining everything from the very beginning as the story's progressing. Gunn has that knack of being able to take a lot of these crazy ideas, a lot of these moments, and kind of transfer a lot of this into live action and onto the big screen. I would have to say that because of all this, The Suicide Squad may be my favorite DC movie of all time. Talk to me in 5 years and see if that holds true. I'd be perfectly fine if this was a one-shot. It's a very self-contained story, but I will have to say, you know, Gunn, you made me greedy. And I want more. I want more of, I don't know who else you're gonna bring in. Solomon Grundy, bring him in there, you know. Condiment King, I wanna see that dude. You know, that would be amazing if it's possible to do that. Who knows? Maybe this could be his new Guardians for the DC universe, make it a trilogy or what have you. I'm curious again to hear what you guys think. Are you guys like planning to watch this movie? Are you gonna watch it in the movie theater, or are you gonna be watching it at home on HBO Max since it is available for streaming same day it's released in theaters? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Don't forget all the YouTube spiel, like, subscribe, you know, follow me on Twitter, spread the word, and as always, stay cool, stay classy, stay safe, and I'll catch all of you in the next one. Peace.